It's Jeffrey Douglas, San Diego Rover. We're up in the ancient bristlecone forest, which above Bishop, California, for the weekend. We're in one of my favorite campgrounds. It's called Grandview. It's about 8,500 feet up in elevation and very busy today. I've never seen as many people here. Usually I have this place almost all to myself. So today we've got the first time to use the Slumberjack Roadhouse tarp. And I saw this the other day on an article, and they were really difficult to get a hold of. In fact, I still think they're very difficult to find one in stock. But why I like it is the awning actually attaches to the back of the car using some straps which go around your wheels, which makes it very secure. Since we do a lot of camping in the desert, places like that where you can get some wind, those points are very secure. And then another advantage for me is with the front runner roof rack, I'm able to attach the three points at the top very securely as well. So the tarp is in a very good condition as far as not blowing away or anything like that. Fairly quick to set up. There's a number of configurations you can do with it. One is probably the most useful one in sunny weather is going ahead and having two poles. And you stake those two poles out and it gives a good deal of shade underneath it. You can also go to using one pole in the center, and I would assume that would be a lot better situation if you're running into some rain or you would like a little bit more privacy, because the center pole then would drop these front panels down a bit. And the last one you can do is actually detach it from the rover or your rig and put another pole and stake it down similar to what you have here, and then it becomes freestanding. So it's really versatile, not very expensive when you look at what you get, relatively well made. The poles are steel, they're not aluminum, so they're not light, but it packs down into a surprising size, so I'm very pleased that it's not very large, and I'm pretty pleased that it's pretty quick to install, and it's very, very secure. They've included some ample guy wires, and they seem to be of ample length and of good quality, and you know, this is their first impression. I'm really anxious to get this out into the desert where I think it's going to really be very useful. I was on the fence about going with what most of our overlander friends do, and that's an ARG awning on the side of the vehicle. And why I like this is because of our drawers and refrigerator and everything working out of the back of the car. This thing just runs naturally from that. You can sit out underneath it at the table with the chairs out, and you're really covered, and it seems to do a really good job. So far, I would say two thumbs up, but we will be back and give you some more reviews once we've had some real world experience with it. And if you thought this video was useful, please like it and subscribe. Have a wonderful day.